Now we will learn how to record discounts that are calculated as a percent of the items that were sold. We offer a different kind of discount to our employees. All employees will receive a 3% discount from any service that they purchase from us. This means that we have to put an expense in the chart of accounts called employee discounts. It also means we have to put an item on the items list called employee discounts. From the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts. In the bottom left, click Account, New. In this case, we will also choose Expense as the account type. Click Continue, and in the account field name, make sure your cap locks is on and type Employee Discount or Discounts. When we click Save and Close, Employee Discounts has been added to the chart of accounts. Now we have to put the item. From the main menu, click List, Item List. In the bottom left, click Item, New. A discount item is type discount. It's a special type of item just for discounts. Click in the name and type in Employee Discount. Now, this time, after you remove the zeros, you type 3 and put in the percent symbol. If you put in the percent symbol, QuickBooks knows this is not going to be a flat money amount. This is going to be a percent of the item that we sell. When we click the account pull down arrow, we will choose employee discounts to be associated with this item. When we click OK, we now have another item on the items list, and you can see this item is another discount type of item, and it's called employee discount. On March 2nd, Holden did 10 editing hours for Candy. She paid cash less the employee discount. From the main menu, click Customers, enter sales receipts. The date was March 2nd. She paid cash. It was customer Candy. Let's make sure that this gets deposited to undeposited funds, because if you get cash, you have to bring it to the bank later. The item, I believe, was editing, so we're going to put that, and the quantity was 10. When we push tab, we have a sales receipt for $1,400. Directly under the editing item, we will click, and we will choose employee discount. Notice, QuickBooks multiplied the $1,400 editing job times 3%, and QuickBooks determined that Candy is entitled to a $42 discount. Therefore, the amount of cash she has to pay is only $1,358. When we click Save and Close, we can open up our trial balance and see that employee discount will show up for the first time as $42. Sometimes we will give a discount for an entire invoice, not just one item. In a case like that, we have to follow several steps to set up the file to be able to do that. Step 1. Add an item to the items list called Subtotal. Step 2. Make the invoice with several items. Step 3. Put the subtotal item under the normal items that we sell. Step 4. Put the discount item under the subtotal. Because the subtotal item gets the total of the entire invoice, then the discount item will take a percent of the subtotal. First, let's take a look how to set it up. From the main menu, click List, Item List. In the bottom left, click Item, New. The type of item is subtotal, and the name will also be subtotal. It's a very simple item. All it does is give you the subtotal of the items that are listed above it on an invoice or a sale receipt. Then you click OK and you're ready to go. Now let's imagine on March 3rd, we gave Alan an employee discount for two items. We gave Alan an employee discount for 9 video and 6 editing. If it's on account, we're going to make an invoice. We open the invoice window, and of course the customer is Alan, and the date is March 3rd. We said that the items were 9 video and 6 editing. So let's put that on the invoice. Video, quantity 9, editing, quantity 6. So this is the way that the invoice would look without the discount. Now, under the items, we have to put the subtotal item. The only thing the subtotal will do is add the items above. Without the discount, this invoice would be $3,540. Now we put the discount item directly under the subtotal. When we choose employee discount, it takes 3% of the subtotal. This way, the entire invoice is being multiplied by the discount percent, and the entire invoice, every item, is being discounted by 3%. Notice the discount amount is $106.20, and the balance of the invoice decreases to $3,433.80. When we click Save and Close, we can look in the trial balance and we see that the employee discount is now up to $148.20. When we double click, we see the reason is we had a sale receipt to Candy where we gave her a $42 discount. We had an invoice to Alan where we gave him $106.20 discount, and that's the reason why the employee discount in total is $148.20.